So today's topic is about plants and their uses in cosmetic industries. In this topic, an overview and history of plants which have been used in cosmetic industries, popular plants and their uses in cosmetics, anti-aging molecules from plants along with bioengineered cosmetic products and future considerations in cosmetic industries will be included. So plants are known to be used in herbal homemade remedies and in many cosmetic products since long ago. Historical evidences suggest that cosmetic products were used by Egyptians and ancient Greeks many years ago. Like Egyptians used eye makeup and cosmetics around 3500 BCE, and the use of hair dyes and makeup for eyes and cheeks became common in Rome in 100 CE. So cosmetics is actually a broad term which includes all skin and body care products, including lotions, creams, sunblocks, massage creams, scrubs, facial masks, lip balms, foundations, toners, anti-aging creams, blushes, mascaras, eyeliners, and shampoos. So in 1879, Procter and Gamble introduced soap for hygiene purposes, and it was followed by Avon brand, which was developed in 1886 as a California perfume company. It was followed by the foundation of many well-known companies which use plants as their major products, and the Pure Food and Drug Act allowed government to regulate cosmetic industry in 1906. So there are so many plants which are used in cosmetic industries due to a lot of reasons. Maybe due to their anti-aging properties, due to their pigmentation, and due to their essential oils. Many plants like marigolds and daisies are known to be used in over 200 cosmetic products, including creams and lotions. So their main activity is due to compounds like triterpene alcohol, saponins, and pigments like carotenoids. So Mexican marigolds contain important molecules like tegetone, linalool, limonene, and linalyl acetate, which are widely used in many cosmetic products. Like if you pick any of your cosmetic product which is coming from Olay, L'Oreal, or Body Shop, you will find some common names like linalool, geraniol, citronellol, and these molecules are actually plant-based molecules which are extracted and isolated from them through different techniques. So linalool is a very common product which is used in a lot of cosmetics, and there are so many sources of linalool like lemongrass, roses, and coriander and mint. So within the coriander formation of essential oils like linalool and its other essential oils takes place in the glandular trichomes, and within the trichomes it is actually the plasters which are synthesizing the essential molecules, and the essential molecules they release from the plasters and then from plasters into the cytosol and then finally out of the trichomes, and they diffuse in the air to attract the pollinators as well as to repel disease causing microbes. So these essential oils simultaneously serve dual purposes, like they serve to attract pollinators and they may also repel certain disease causing microbes. So there are many techniques which are used for the isolation of essential oils, like steam distillation. So steam distillation, in here you can see that through steam distillation, essential oils of plants are extracted, and linalool is the most common essential oil which is used in a variety of products. So in addition to this, essential oils of plants like rose, jasmine, daffodils, daisies, and orange, they are also used in variety of cosmetic products. So plants like aloe vera, they are also used in many anti-aging products. It is actually due to the fact that many plant stem cells do not undergo aging process due to their hormones like auxins and gibberellins. So the research is focusing on the use of stem cells from plant meristems containing these phytohormones in anti-aging products in order to delay the process of aging. So Nova Cell is actually a plant stem cell anti-aging night cream which is made from the meristematic cells of mung beans. They are rich in many antioxidants and provide protection to plants against UV radiations. So these creams are not tested on animals, and therefore they are 100% cruelty free products. So although many anti-aging skincare products are available in market, however, plant stem cell-based cosmetic products are rare, and this is something where biotechnologies need to work in future. So turmeric is also a common plant which has been used since almost 4,000 years ago by many, you know, by Asian and African countries, and it is a perennial herb, and its rhizome is used as a powder, which is a popular spice flavor in Asian cuisine. So the medicinal and the anti-aging properties of turmeric are due to the group of compounds like curcuminoids of rhizomes, and they prevent aging of skin due to the inhibition of matrix metalloproteinases expression, which is actually responsible for aging process. So curcumin, which is the compound for from turmeric, its administration can also increase the activities of oxidative defense system, and it extends the life of certain animals through the expression of aging genes. So in addition to this, flower extract of magnolia is also known to decrease the melanin content in the skin cells, which indicate the potential use of plants in skin care products. So aloe vera is also known to be wonder plant, and it is one of the most popular plant which is used in many anti-aging products, as it may act to improve the skin fibroblast and accelerate the collagen production process. Therefore, it is being used in many skin care products like scrubs and face polishers and other cosmetic products due to its anti-aging properties. So aloe gel leaf is actually used to rejuvenate and to tone skin in many commercial products, and aloin, a brown gel of aloe, is used as sunscreen factor in many skincare products. So here you can see that aloe vera is used in many anti-aging products due to its ability to strengthen collagen fiber of skin and in improving the fibroblast cell structure. It is actually due to the inhibitory effects on collagenase and elastase enzymes at MPP1, which can cause wrinkles on the skin, while the aloe gel or the aloin in leaves has wound healing properties due to their effects on rapid maturation of collagen, and therefore it is used as skin a sunscreen factor in many cosmetic products. So there is a lot of research which need to be conducted in order to improve the cosmetic products, like the concepts of eco-respectful chemicals need to be promoted. Although it's a big challenge for industries to go green, therefore there is a need to explore further biochemical nature of plants in order to replace harmful chemicals with the natural products in cosmetic industries. But it is also important that the use of plants for making anti-aging products, which are specifically coming from the stem cells, it need to be promoted. So in addition to this, the concept of bioengineered perfumes and the bioengineered products should also be promoted. Thank you.